everyone. Thank you for tuning in here today, the Reflection Show in the Mirror. And I'm excited to be right back here in Columbus, Georgia for this amazing movie that's been going on, the shooting here behind the scenes for My Brother's Keeper. And I'm excited to have the one and only You guys saw him at the International Christian Film and Music Festival, and he was all, he was part of the team. And Joel, I'm excited to have you here back on the show here where you've been talking about the movie My Brother's Keeper.
Yeah.
Tell me, what is your experience here today?
Experience has been great. I mean, today and every day we've been here. We've been here about 2 weeks now. We're going on our third week starting today. We're at the Middletown Coffee House, shooting today some, you know, a lot of the dramatic elements of the script.
Yeah.
But Columbus, I got to tell you, man, Columbus, Georgia has just been, they opened arms, welcomed us with open arms, man. Just community came out to support us.
Yeah.
A lot of vendors, a lot of stores, a lot of just people came out. I mean, we had one day where we had over 400 background.
400?
We had to turn people away.
400?
400
And that's
people.
Just for the extra?
Just for the extra.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so, tell me something unique about these actor and actress that you have involved in this powerful movie.
Well, you know, T.C. Stallings, man, you know, with that guy is just, that who you see on camera and the roles that he plays, you know, about being a strong, godly man, that's who he is in real life. I've been blessed to work with him now. This will be our third film, and he has something coming up where I'll be, he's bringing me in as a producer as well.
Wow.
So, you know, I'm excited about that. Yeah, you know what I mean? And so, you know, who you see there on screen and what you think he's like, you know, he is like that.
Wow.
You know, just a genuine, genuine man of God. I've gotten to work with Keisha Knight Pulliam, who, which for me was a great delight. Obviously, like a lot of people were like, oh my God, it's Rudy.
And she's very transparent, and she is so cool, y'all. I'm telling you, man, this is someone, she has a beautiful soul.
Beautiful soul, and her daughter Ella is so beautiful, and her daughter's here with us as well, and her mom. So, you know, just getting to see her and how she interacts with her daughter. So, just, you know, that's just a good person right there, you know, that's a good person. And working with Robert Rashad is on set.
Mm-hmm.
Blue Kimball is on set.
Right.
We have Gregory Allen Williams who started today.
Right.
And you know, it's been fun. You know, it's been a lot of fun. We got live sound going on, people.
Hey guys, don't forget this show is unscripted. You see me sweating. We are out here and we're making it happen because we want to bring the exclusive interview just for you. And talking about these stories of these actors and actresses.
Yeah.
So tell me, as far as to see this come the way it's happening.
Yeah.
What is that feeling that is running through your soul?
Just satisfaction.
Yeah.
You know, I told you, I think I mentioned to you down at the International Christian Film Festival that, you know, this isn't just one more notch on my belt as a film that I'm doing. You know, I'm doing these for God. I'm doing this. This is my ministry.
Right.
You know, so to have read this script, you know, a little bit over 5 months ago.
Wow, 5 months.
5 months ago, and you know, when Ty Mads approached me as producing it, coming in as their senior producer, you know, I read the script and just touched my heart, man. It just touched my heart. My own brother suffers from PTSD as well and other mental issues. So, you know, mental illness issues.
Right.
Let me correct myself there. So, you know, I saw the potential in this. And then it had that message in there, you know, that God, you know, you come to God with your problems and come to God with these type of situations.
Wow.
You know, not everything gets fixed right away, but that's
true.
A good place to start. Mm. You know, that's a good place to start. So just to see this come together and just, you know, having read the stuff, you know, when you read the scene, you know, Travis puts a gun to his head and you're thinking, okay, but then seeing TC do that, man.
He brings it to life.
Oh man, he brings it to life, man. He does. He brings it to life. So yeah, I'm just, you know, so proud of him too, as well as an actor, to see how far he's grown and where he's going.
Yes.
And the role, and he's just taking on this role, this role full punch.
And you know, talking about TC and his role, you know, even with this other project that he's working on.
Yeah.
What is so important that people should know when it comes to partnership, the value behind it?
Look, I'm just of the belief that I'm a loyal person, you know what I mean? It's just transparency, loyalty, you know, and the way that I've been blessed. I say I've been blessed because I've gotten to work with some actors that I grew up watching, you know?
Right.
And people say, oh, well, you know, you're still not making those big Hollywood movies. You know, we've talked about that.
Right,
I've shared my opinion on that stuff. You know what I mean? I'm doing what I love. I'm doing it for the Lord.
Right.
I'm getting to work with people like TC, like Keisha.
Yeah.
You know, I've worked with other actors as well. And just, I've gotten to this point in my life because I'm just me. I'm not pretending to be Mr. Hollywood. I'm not coming in with an ego. Yeah, just I'm being myself and being genuine. Mm. You know, and God is going to put me and he's going to call me where I'm needed, where I'm supposed to be.
Right.
You know, a good friend of mine told me once, I don't want to be where I want to be. I don't want to be where I'm wanted. I want to be where I'm called upon.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
Say that again.
I don't want to be where I want to be, where I'm wanted.
Right.
I want to be where I'm called upon.
Called to be.
Called to be by God.
Wow.
So,
that is powerful.
And just be true. Just be honest with yourself about that. Accept that. Be unashamed, unapologetic about it.
Right.
I am serving God in these movies. So,
That's what I love about you, Joel, is the fact that from the minute we spoke and we connected, everything has been transparent.
Yeah.
And you know, today in time, it's hard to find those who are truly transparent in what they're called to do.
Yeah.
Who they're called to be and how they're called to be in your life and how to change you and impact your life. And I truly want to say thank you for being yourself.
Yeah.
Now this movie is coming out and the world needs to see it.
Yeah, we're talking to different distributors. We already have a lot of distributors reaching out to us already because of our social media push. And you know, and again, if you have your viewers watch, you know, hashtag MBK the movie.
Right. Hashtag MBK the movie.
Or on Instagram, they can follow us at MBK _ movie.
Okay.
And but we've already had three distributors. About three, I think there might have been a fourth one this morning that contacted us, interested in finding out. So right now we're projecting maybe like a release date in February 2019.
Okay.
You know, those things always change here and there, but we are definitely going to do a theatrical run. We have over 16,000 churches praying for us.
Wow, 16,000.
The executive producer, Bishop Charles Mackey, who you met. I mean, that man has been out there and just getting these churches behind us. Some of them have even, you know, invested with us.
Wow.
You know what I mean? So we're definitely going to be doing a theatrical run.
And that's beautiful.
Yeah.
Guys, this is why it's important for you guys to see this movie that's getting ready to come out next year, My Brother's Keeper. And remember, hashtag MBK the movie.
Yes.
And Instagram, MBK _
movie.
Movie.
Yep.
You guys need to definitely get out there when you see this movie drop. Support it. There is a cause. There is an awareness. But there's also a mission. Guys, I'm here with Joel right here on The Reflection Show. Ramsey Rezard in the mirror. And remember, your experience matters.
You can't wait on other people to be what you've been called to be. You can't wait on their affirmation.
To all my Facebook and Instagrammers, how you guys doing today? I'm so excited to be tuning in right here, right now, as you're watching this. I wanted to do a quick announcement. My show now, The Reflection Show, airs at 9 p.m. every Thursday. You asked for it, I'm giving it to you. So make sure you share, like, comment, and also don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right down here in the Mirror TV on our YouTube channel. We want you to be a part of this journey. Thank you all so much for being a part of this journey. I'm so thankful for all of your support, and I definitely want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And remember, your experience matters.